I'm all about quick, easy, and effective post-processing for my nature photos, and the new Pure Raw software from DxO promises to let us start with the absolute best versions of our raw files. How does it work? Here's my quick review. Hola amigos, Greg Basco in a hotel room somewhere, don't ask. I recently did a full, really in-depth, comprehensive review of DxO Pure Raw for nature photography. If you want to take a look at that, check out the link below. It's a long one, but packed with information. But I wanted to give you a really, really quick rundown of my conclusions from that video. I do a lot in my nature photography, everything from macro to wildlife to landscapes to birds to remote setups, camera trapping, even aerial photography with drones. So I wanted to see how DxO Pure Raw might be able to help me and give me a jump start on my post-processing for all of those types of photos. I broke it down into 6 questions. I'm going to go through those with you right now, and I'm going to give a little check mark or a little X according to where DxO Pure Raw I think will fit into my workflow. The first question, or the first case scenario that I looked at, was for high ISO photos, you know, telephoto type bird and wildlife photography taken in low light with newer cameras. And I can tell you there, DxO Pure Raw is a winner and gets a check because it handled the raw files beautifully and let me start out without having even to go to Lightroom or Photoshop to do any selective noise reduction at all. So that's a real game changer and a real time saver for me. What could you do with that time? You could subscribe to my YouTube channel right now, or maybe to my Instagram feed. I then looked at how DxO Pure Raw might help me with night landscape photos where we're fighting all types of sensor noise, whether it's from a long exposure or from high ISOs, you know, where we shoot those cool starry skies. And I'll tell you what, it did a great job and it gets another check because it really handled the noise beautifully in starry skies without wiping out some of the fainter stars. And it also helped to really bring back or even create some detail in dark foreground areas. And so it really worked well. I'm going to be using it a lot for my night landscapes from now on. I then looked at what DxO Pure Raw could do for files taken with older cameras that were great in their day, but these days just don't compare in terms of high ISO performance, dynamic range, all those sorts of things. And I'll tell you what, DxO Pure Raw again earned another check because it did a really good job breathing new life and detail and color fidelity into those old favorites of ours. And so I think it's a real game changer for that as well, and I'm going to be using it to take a look at lots of my older photos over the next few months. Now, what about high contrast landscape photos, even taken with the latest, greatest cameras that have good dynamic range? Would DxO Pure Raw help us to extract even more clean shadow detail from dark foreground areas in, let's say, landscape images? And I found that it actually could. I don't think this is going to be a huge thing. I'm not going to be running every one of my newer present and future landscape photos through DxO Pure Raw. But in those cases where I think I really, really might want to push the shadows to kind of an extreme extent, in my limited testing, I found that DxO Pure Raw would give us cleaner, smoother, but still detailed shadowed information in those shadows. So another check mark there. I'll use it once in a while. What about those photos we all have that we took at a low ISO? We have them perfectly exposed. They're just dead on, tack sharp. Would DxO Pure Raw offer any benefits in terms of processing those photos? In my testing, I found that it didn't. And so I'm going to give it an X. That doesn't seem really fair. It's not really a knock. I don't think it was designed to work on those photos where you just see them right out of the camera and you're like, wow, do I need to do anything to this at all? Probably not. But I found that DxO Pure Raw tended to over sharpen things, and you can deal with that to an extent in post-processing, but I just found there's no reason to. So if you have a great file taken at a low ISO with perfect exposure and perfect sharpness, DxO Pure Raw probably isn't going to help you at all. And finally, I wanted to know if DxO Pure Raw would even work on drone photos, and I'll tell you, it does work, I'll tell you that, and it also does a fantastic job. You know, in drone photography, you're often fighting high ISO noise from those little tiny sensors, even at lower ISOs, and you can also get some weird color shifts, maybe just due to the drone sensor themselves, or if you're using filters. I use a lot of filters in my drone photography, circular polarizer and ND filters, and so I've found that DxO Pure Raw really pulled out some amazing detail and cleaned up noise, and also just did an incredible job removing color casts from drone images. So big time check for drone photography. All right, I hope you enjoyed that. That was a quick one. If you want to know much more about DxO Pure Raw, do be sure to check out my in-depth, comprehensive, very long video review, linked to down below. Of course, if you enjoyed this video, give me a like, hit the subscribe button so you'll be notified next time I post a new video. And on that subject, a number of readers have asked me what I thought about Topaz Denoise and Sharpen AI compared to DxO Pure Raw. And I'll tell you what, I don't think they're actually comparable products. DxO Pure Raw offers a wider range of benefits and on a wider range of image types. That's a topic for a future video coming soon. Stay tuned, and I'll see you next time.